last year I saw this challenge on Instagram to camp out one night each month of the year, and I thought, wow, that would be epic. But January can be challenging in the UK, so I put a post up on social media asking if anybody would like to join me, hoping for one or two people to join. But actually, in the end, we had 25 people that turned up for a campout in January, which is mental. We went to the New Forest, which is in the south of England, and it's absolutely beautiful. It's really flat, it's really beautiful gravel tracks. Everyone was very cool, but very happy, and I think that's a good sign when, despite it being really cold, everyone still had an amazing time. And I think from there, it made me realise how many ideas or dreams or challenges exist in people's heads, but they never come into reality because either you don't have the accountability or you don't have somebody to go with. They just don't happen. And I thought, we should do something to change this. And then Bikepacking Buds was born.
Bikepacking Buds is more of the smiles over miles attitude when it comes to cycling. It doesn't matter what you're wearing, how many miles you're doing, the elevation profile, as long as you're in nature and with nice people.
We want to have this amazing community where everyone gets involved and everyone feels like a big family. That's really what we want to create. It's a community of like-minded cyclists that like to get out on adventures and share them together. The main goal is to get more people out bikepacking and having a good time on their bikes. And then we realised that there was actually lots of different barriers that were stopping people from joining bikepacking trips.
I was personally really scared of group rides until quite recently, because I always thought I was going to be the slowest one. And then once you pass that barrier, you realize how much fun it is. And we just want more people outside on the bikes, meeting people, making connections, and just slowly building that community where just everyone wants to join, just feeling a bit more safe.
To do that, what we want to do is break down those barriers that are stopping people going out. So whether that be that they don't have anyone to go with, or they don't know what the right equipment is, or they don't have any experience with camping, all these different things, we want to try and give people the opportunity that they can join a trip. So we've put together multiple different resources to break down those barriers and build that knowledge.
We have the blog, which is a way of sharing tips, answering the main questions, which might sound silly, but they're not. Everyone has the same questions.
We have a podcast that comes out every fortnight. We speak to different members of the community. We really want to get people's stories, big and small, not necessarily cycling around the world, but just going on a bikepacking adventure with their toddler or their child, or lots of different varieties of people on there that are doing really cool stuff in the bikepacking and cycling world.
We are organising a monthly webinar which we call a virtual campfire, where we're going through different topics from the kit to what food to pack, how to plan your routes. They're free to join to make them more accessible to public.
There are so many parts of Bikepacking Buds that makes it a really rewarding experience. We're running community trips every weekend. We have a podcast, we have a blog, we have webinars. It's freaking awesome. So the rides and the routes are proposed and are open for all the community to participate in. We have a form where they choose how many people they want to come on the trip with them, how many nights, the route, the mileage, the elevation.
Based on that, someone can just make the decision whether their fitness level matches that. And that's a way of just making it so much more smooth.
Once they submit that trip, we then advertise the trip and they simply sign up, come along and have the best time of their lives.
We have trips to suit everyone and all levels. We have very beginner-friendly rides, which are at party pace. We have a lot of hiker bike enthusiasts in our trips. So it really depends who opens up the trip.
And we are trying to offer a beginner's trip every other month so that those that feel not confident at all, they can just come party pace with a lot of snacks and stops. The adventure doesn't have to be super challenging as long as you're having fun and just like freeing your mind and making connections. That's all that matters.
Everyone's been so friendly and it's kind of encouraging on the rides when you go for long rides, when you want to give up, and there's other people encouraging you, and it's kind of the team spirit, really.
It's about supporting everyone. No one cares if you need to stop, no one cares if you need to cut short, no one cares if you only join for a bit.
We all have different knowledges. We come from different countries. It's pretty cool that we have that. So inclusivity and diversity is something that is core to our beliefs. There's a phrase that says, you only protect what you love and you only love what you know. And we understand that the best way to get other people to care about the environment is actually to go outside and connect with nature, have an amazing time in it, and then see these beautiful, wonderful things. And from there, that makes you care, gives you this passion to protect it. The UK is wicked. It's a really small country, but it's so diverse in terms of the gravel. We've got big mountains in Scotland, flat, beautiful, smooth, fast gravel in the New Forest, rugged coastlines. Everywhere you go is completely different, and that's what makes it so fun to explore.
Cycling is a great tool to get out there and connect with the environment, to be closer to the nature, to connect with people. You get away from the noise. You have that space, that headspace we sometimes all need so much.
Gravel especially means you can get away from the noise and the busy roads and get completely immersed into the wild. And you get there places otherwise that you wouldn't be able to get to unless you went on foot. But on a bike, you can go so much further, so much quicker than you would be able to on foot. Like, you can go places in a car, you can go far in a car, but you never get to feel the terrain. You don't get to feel the wind on your face or the rain or any of those things that really make you feel alive. And I think that's why I love cycling.
That feeling when you leave your house with your fully loaded bike and you just have every single thing you need. It's such a feeling of freedom and self-sufficiency.
You can literally go anywhere. There's nothing that stops you, anything, anywhere you want to go. It may take a long time, but you'll get there eventually.
There's so many moments when you're cycling that you just feel so empowered, so powerful, so independent, so free. Just the feeling you have when you're going downhill, when you fix your first mechanical, when you pitch your tent and you have the sunset.
That sense of self-achievement and believing that you can do it and it's possible, that carries through to day-to-day life. That makes you think, if I've just done that, I can do anything. The world is my oyster. Anything is possible.
That feeling of owning like yourself and that moment, it's amazing.
That feeling is just so beautiful that everyone has to try it at least once.